No.
That was, what, 62 years ago?
The last time I saw that was probably when it aired.
My first lines. Hold on.
I do remember that scene.
Did Chris Maloney remember his first lines? Because if he did, I'm going to be so jealous.
I remember it took him 5 hours to set up because it wasn't really raining.
Cigars. Raining.
$40 left in the cigar box.
Is it possible that my first lines were my name? Somebody asked me who I was, or I came on the crime scene and I said Olivia Benson?
Sex crime?
Olivia Benson.
Elliot Stable.
What?
I remember the best line of that scene, which was, sometimes a cigar is just a cigar, or something like that. And he goes, yeah, well, that guy's cigar is missing. And I looked in there and I look out, and Mariska and I look at each other like, oh.
Sometimes a cigar is just a cigar. Is there a specific reason you called us out? Whoever did this sliced off his cigar and took it with him. Is that specific enough?
Works for me.
You're asking me to go back 13 years. No, I cannot. My character was brought on because Detective Green was involved in a shooting, so I remember showing up to investigate this shooting. So here I am. But what I said, how I said it, who I said it to, cannot recall.
Recognize one big hole in him over there. How many shots did you fire?
Two.
Detective Green's not answering questions until he consults his union attorney.
We're just making conversation, Lieutenant. There's no need to get our hackles up.
I'm internal affairs. The cops don't like to be policed by themselves. But I was so great at my job that they couldn't deny bringing me into their precinct.
My first lines ever on SVU, I walked into the squad room and I was taking Michelle Hurst's job. She played a character, Jeffries, and it was so cold because they wrote it into the script. I walked in and I said something to her and she says, you're here for my job. I goes, that's awkward. And she goes, imagine how I feel. And that was really her last line on the show.
Monique Jeffries, maybe I can help.
Then to dwell, I've been reassigned.
You're here for my job.
This is awkward.
Well, try my side in a moment.
Give SVU thumbs up for being a very cold-blooded situation when it comes to getting rid of people.
I played a victim on SVU before I ever got cast as a detective. I do know that I worked with Ice-T for most of it. The very first scene I shot on SVU as a detective was me carrying a box of things and being like a little eager beaver to say, hi, I'm here, I'm ready to learn, and you know, I've heard a lot about you. Hey, I'm Detective Rollins. I think it went something like that.
Oh, Captain Cragen.
Excuse me?
I'm Detective Amanda Rollins. You interviewed me last month.
Well, you picked a hell of a first day. I'll fill you in later.
You can fill me in now. Hey, stash that for me somewhere, hon. Thank you. I'm ready to work.
Great.
25, 26, how many years ago is it? I have no clue.
Claire Kincaid.
Jack McCoy. I spoke to Mr. Schiff. He said you had requested me.
As soon as I heard Bennett resign, your reputation precedes you.
As does yours.
I don't remember it at all, but I will never forget Jill Hennessy.
Well, I've done quite a few Law & Orders in the different iterations, and I don't really remember what my first one was on Criminal Intent, original Law & Order, or Trial by Jury, or even SVU, because I was a different character, but my first line is Carisi, I do remember, and I think it was, they shot at us right outside of the station, so they wanted us to know they're crazy. And then I had a bunch of Zeppelins and a mustache.
They shot at cops right outside of the station, so they want us to know they're crazy.
You must be my new detective.
Dominic Carisi Jr. Call me Sonny. Brought Zeppeli.
What was happening that day? I was nervous because I didn't want to blow it, and I was making sure I knew my lines. I kind of remember walking. I was like, this is how a cop would walk. And I don't know, doing some character stuff and trying to really get into it in the way that you would when you're really, really amped up. The mustache, yeah, that was awesome. I can't believe they let me do that. Then we decided maybe that wasn't the best idea.
Yes, I do remember my first line on Law & Order Organized Crime. I was in Coney Island and on the Ferris wheel, and I was getting ready to kill my father.
Get in. Don't be a sissy.
And it was exciting because I was, as a kid, I used to go to Coney Island with my own dad. My lines, I can't remember. Oh, I remember I was talking about swinging my legs as a little boy, being on the Ferris wheel with my dad in the show. Yes.
My first lines ever were not like, hi, how are you? Oh my God, I'm a math professor. So it was really ridiculously complicated. If F is the equivalent of the identity module QX minus X, I think that's it. Mathematicians don't rake me over the coals for that one, because it's probably totally wrong, but it ended up being something entirely different anyway.
The Culler-Jones polynomial at the nth root of unity has this simple expression.
My first line in the show, technically, is, you want me to hack this phone. But in the script, my actual first line was copy. And we added in the real first line in ADR after we actually shot the whole episode. You want me to hack this phone?
Calls and texts have been wiped. We can't get anything off it.
Copy.
And the owner's dead, so this is my last best chance of getting him to tell me what he was all about.
Copy.
I think it was something like, I have 500,000 followers on Instagram.
He reps a clothing line, a vape brand, a photo sharing app.
For what it's worth, I got about 40 million Insta followers. That's what it was! For what it's worth, I got 40 million Insta followers, yes.